that was close.
Well, these cliff dwellers are hard to kill with a spear. Sometimes I wish I had my own night out here and in this beautiful country trying to chase these beasts, but I love the challenge of this spear, man. And we're in black today as I work these cliffs, and there's no shortage of cliffs and obviously no shortage of goats, but so far no blood on my spear. But boy, am I having lots of fun here in New Zealand. As you pan around, or I pan around, you can see it's a vast country. There's dotted farms in the distance and rolling hills saturated with trees and gulches like this up and down. The animals live in among farmers, and then there's vast areas that spread for literally tens of miles without roads, and they just proliferate inside those areas, and the animals bleed off into this other country like this, and that's where it turns into fun for guys like me.
New Zealand, an island of wild wonder with a rich wilderness, forests that stretch from coast to coast, with a lush cover that conceals a wealth of wildlife. We have arrived, and we are ambitious to reap the bounty of this beautiful land. We're sure glad you joined us. I'm Tim Wells, the Slock Master. And I use Morel Targets, Carbon Express Arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use Cold Steel Knives. I light them up with Luminox and wear Mossy Oak Camo. I kill animals with Grim Reapers. Advanced Taxidermy brings them to life. I use Muzzy for big fish and put their meat in Canyon Coolers. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from Tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call, and I drive a Ford truck, 'cause Ford trucks are tough. Where else could a man test his most primitive hunting skills than here in the land down under? Where red stags, sika, fallow, and wild goats abound by the thousands. Today I'm in relentless pursuit, hoping to blow gun or spear one of these magnificent beasts. And with enough patience, I should be able to get it done. Day 6 of a 14-day hunt, and I've only had one red stag within spear range, and that fell through for me, but way off in the middle of nowhere, I have found a wallow. I found a well-used trail not far from the wallow. Climbed up in a tree, then broke some branches off so there's fresh leaves right under my tree. Then made my wait. I'm on a really well-used trail. Here. I hear them coming. They're fighting as they come. I can hear bulls below me fighting. Animals will often pass by the tree, but you need something directly under you to lure them that last little distance. And after 2 days of waiting, the plan was coming together. But despite my good luck, that's about as far as they came. They had walked 500 yards up the mountain, only to turn around and head back down. Honestly, I think they probably smelled me. I hadn't showered in 3 days.
That's as close as I can get so far. He was in spear range, but there was too much debris between me and him.
Sometimes waiting is more than I can take. And today a ground attack is in order. A red stag has roared below me. I'm hiding behind a tree on a ridge just above him. He's headed my way. And now there's more coming my way. Well, I got this red stag, but not with the pointy end of my spear. The handle landed right on his back. I was bummed out, for red stags are the coveted jewel of New Zealand's deer species, and my friend Dane has closed in on a massive stag now. He's snoozing on the edge of his wallow. Stag remains in his bed. He's quartered away. And if Dane can make a good shot, there's a nice little window to thread the arrow to the mark.
Hey man, that ain't an Oregon butt bulb, but that'll work.
That'll work, huh? Got him.
Spot and stalked him in his bed, brother. Nice work.
Thanks, man. Long shot, longer we wanted to take, but we got him.
Good job, let's check him out.
Wow.
Look at that. What a beautiful animal. Whoa. talk out loud now, buddy. You got him.
Got him.
It's that boy. What do you think, Joey?
Oh, awesome. Awesome, bro. Beautiful purling. Good colors. Everything our man wanted.
Way to go, Dane. But with a fat stag down, we were just about to realize how much work it can be when you're in remote country. Waiting is what I do best. Sometimes for hours. And sometimes for days. There's no wind today. Normally that's good for hunting, but not when you're spear hunting. It's bad, for your prey can hear the slightest move you make when you try to spear them, because they've got to be close. And Fala and Sika deer are skitzed out, and boy can they move fast. The throw will have to be perfect. Yep, it's hard. Time to get down and head for a hot shower. Well, the nice thing is the camp mascot right here. When you get back to camp, she's always waiting. There she is. What's your name, Joe?
Piper.
Piper is quite the little mascot. Piper, what you doing? Oh, come here, come here. She's a sweetheart. Bottle fed.
Well, when she grows up, she'll be one of those. What is it, Rob, that she's called?
Arapara.
Parapara?
Arapara.
Arapara. All right. Piper, go play with the dog. We know what you want to do there.
Yee-hee! Kick him up! Kick him up, buddy! Woohoo! Kick up your heels. Kick him up. Atta girl. Kick him up. Atta girl, Leo.
A big fallow deer is just ahead. He's grazing with his head down. I may be able to cut the distance and get within spear range. Nope, he must have heard me. New Zealand's wild goats present the perfect challenge for the blowgun hunter. For one, there's lots of them. And they live within the broken slopes of the forest edge. It's here that you can use the terrain to close the distance. That's what I'm doing now. I'm using the cover to get close, belly crawling in on the feeding billy. The tall grass breaks up my silhouette as I inch forward. While keeping a low profile, I allow gravity to help me belly crawl even nearer to the feeding billy. For if I'm going to kill an animal of this size with a razor dart, I'll need a clear, close shot at his vitals. Eventually, the goat steps over a small embankment. This is my chance. I'm 10 yards out. The soil is moist and soft, perfect for a still hunt. Yep, I'm skylined and the billy now sees me. The shot was perfect. And the dart has entered the billy's lungs. But the goat has no clue that he's about to die.
got me a billy. Pure white one. Wow. Whew. Check it out. How's that for dart placement right there, buddy? All right. He didn't make it 25 yards. Ran down in the valley up the other side. And he let out a death scream, and that's where he dropped right here. It's pretty awesome. You can kill as many goats here in New Zealand as you'd like to. They actually have so many goats that they ruin the timber, so they fly with helicopters and shoot them like we shoot hogs at home. They're invasive. And so me hunting and killing a few goats is no big deal. And they're pretty good to eat, so nothing gets wasted. I got some nice trophies, some nice furs, and this is awesome. I love hunting with my blowgun. Well, we're gonna take care of this guy and get out of here.
It was amazing to me just how many goats there were. For after throwing branches on the ground, in less than a day they would find it. The following day I would come back, add more branches on the ground, and sure enough, here they'd come. I never felt guilty for shooting the goats. There was plenty. And come to find out, the government will actually fly the area and kill them all if you don't keep their numbers in check. So hunting proved to be a good thing. We were trying to keep the balance. Lunch is served.
Another goat takes the dart. It looked like a good hit. Putting those leaves on the ground has really drawn the goats to me and made it perfect for the blowgun. It was the perfect angle. I put my dart right in the honey hole. It looked like top of the lung down through the heart. So the goat ran up the hill though and just went out of sight in the brush, but I got a good feeling about it. I'm pretty sure I got him good. All right, let's go. Let's go climb out of this tree stand and see if we can find him. And I can tell you right now, that's the best eating size. If you're gonna eat a goat, you might as well eat a young one that's tender. And came off that hill. Just like, I don't care what part of the world you're on, if you double lung or you mortally hit an animal, they don't go uphill, at least very seldom do they. And shot the goat up over the top of this ridge about 75 yards. And wasn't a real good trail, but there never is with the blowgun, but that's why you want to make a perfect shot. And here it is. You got to look out for this stuff. This is stinging nettle, only it's deadly stinging nettle. If you would zoom in on that, Jared, you can see those tiny little pricks on there. And if they prick your finger or touch you on the face, both my hands right now are tingling because I got on both of my hands about 3 days ago and it's just starting to go away. Actually, it was hard to sleep at night because of the pain, just from those, just brushing against it. You don't have to grip it or nothing. Just if you brush against it, it got you. So the goat died where it tried to get me on this one, tried to get me on that one. But in the end, all right, about a 40-pound goat, perfect blowgun size. Okay, so we're gonna do something different here because Jared and I are at least a two-hour journey out of here to go back and get food or get gear. So today we want to spend the day and then the evening and get up the next morning out here in the woods and get after them again, because my time's running short. But we do have some meat now, and I'm gonna dress this goat. Okay, so I just cut out the hind quarter with the cold steel, and about the right amount for two guys to eat for dinner tonight. And we will make a nice camp meal out of this, but we got more hunting to do, so let's get after it.
I'd have to say that spear hunting the cliffs of New Zealand's North Island was about as much fun as anything I'd ever did.
Threw it 50 yards and just over his back. I actually only threw it 10 yards, but it was straight downhill. Daggone it. Look at him. Dressed in black. They think I'm a goat up here. We're good. Gerald gave me a good tip. Oh boy.
See him?
The New Zealand's feral goat population is a mixture of numerous species. So they come in various sizes and colors. Some are just plain beautiful. And Kerry is hoping to bring home a coat of many colors. Unfortunately for this big billy, she set her Oneida sights on him.
Looking at us.
And if he gives us the chance, Kerry will airmail a Grim Reaper his way.
We were going to be here another week, but the coronavirus has shut all traffic down, so we have 2 days to get home. We have to leave in the morning. We were hoping for a big, beautiful ram. She pinwheeling. Yeah.
Nice shot, kiddo.
Let's go get him. Are you following the blood?
Thank you.
blood.
Well, she got her billy. He's got a beautiful cape on him.
Look how thick this is. I mean, it is thick as my fingers. It is a beautiful billy goat. We picked him out of the pack just because of his colors. Most guys hunt horns, but Kerry wanted a beautiful rug, so we went to looking, and there's so many goats. We found one that was just beautiful. He's got black legs with tan on them and a big white spot right here. He actually has pretty good horns, a black face with a little white trim on his front of his eyeballs. And look at that beard. It's not as good as Jared's, but it's pretty darn close.
You don't want to make a rug out of my one too, do you?
I'm Jared's first spear slash blowgun hunter he's had ever in New Zealand. But man, we had a good time this week. And Kerry's put the whopping on some goats and on some deer, and it's been a lot of fun. We were hoping to hunt stags further into next week, but the coronavirus has shut down all travel after tomorrow, so we got to go home and cut our trip short, which is a real bummer. But hopefully all of you folks back home are safe and healthy, and we'll be back in a couple days. But for now, Kerry has scored once again. She is a killer. The Oneida sent the scud to its mark.
How are we going to get it mopped?
That's the guide's problem. So here is a yearling sika deer, or a fallow deer, and my first deer here in New Zealand with a blowgun. Given it's a cull deer, doesn't have big antlers or anything, but impressed with the knockdown power of a blowgun if it's put in the right spot. But anyway, about 70 pound animal, a lot of good meat on fallow. That's the one of the Kiwis' favorite foods is the fallow meat, and we got a nice one here. So even though she's only 80 pounds, I got a long way to go to get out of here, so I'm gonna get after it. But blowgun death right here in New Zealand. It's been pretty awesome.